Hello, and welcome to my 37th book synopsis after a gap of 1 year. The name of the book that I'm going to do synopsis today is The War That Made Raw. It is not actually Raw, it is R&AW, Research and Analysis Wing, but we call it Raw. Coincidentally, The War That Made Raw was a Bangladesh war, and last month itself, Bangladesh celebrated its 50th independence. That's a coincidence. Let us come to the book. First of all, we need to understand the need to establish the RAW. With the huge intelligence failure in 1962 war against China and one more war coming in 1965, it was felt necessary that we should definitely have across the country international intelligence, and that's why the then Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhiji, established RAW in 1968. Next question, who should lead that? The only name that came in mind prominently was Mr. Rameshwar Nath Kao, K-A-O. Why? History for that as well. In 1955, a chartered Air India plane named Kashmir Princess was blown mid-air when it was flying from Hong Kong to Jakarta. That investigation was led by Mr. Kao, and he spent considerable time and effort to unearth the villains or who did actually that blast. His skills including super intelligence, calmness, ability to collect the data, process it and come to the conclusion, as well as to get things done from a lot of people, earned him a huge respect. Second aspect, in 1956, the first one was 1955, immediately after that 1956, he was appointed as the chief security of Jawaharlal Nehruji, who was prime minister at that point of time, and in 1958, he was asked to create or help Ghana, South African country, to create an intelligence agency. Though it was not there in India, he was asked to create that. So obviously all these things which he had done helped him to become the first chief of RAW. Now let's come to the main story. This book is primarily on the Bangladesh war, and how did we win this war for Bangladesh and for us. RAW, under the leadership of Mr. Kao and his juniors, which were called as cowboys, okay, did play a very critical role as far as getting the information from East Pakistan, West Pakistan, that is Pakistan and Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka was also important because when we had decided to stop air travel for Pakistan, they tried to send lot of machinery, lot of weapons through Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka was also a key factor in this. And the way in which they planted the agents, the way in which they could get the information on time, and that lot, the help that was made by sitting behind the desk, was immensely helpful for our armed forces to defeat Pakistani forces and won the independence for Bangladesh. And that is why it says that the war that made RAW, because this war made RAW, and after this RAW was recognized as a premier institute, and even today it is known as a very premier institute. One of the reasons why this book is important for me, because this was gifted by my son to me. Apart from that, I am not going to say anything, because war stories should be read and should not be told. So I have given the hints, but you should read it yourself. This is definitely an interesting book, written in a captivating book, a small book, not a big one. This is the book. Okay, it is maybe 200 pages book, 250 pages book. You can read it maybe in a couple of days, if you don't have time, full day available. This book is written by two people, as I said. One is Anusha Nandakumar, who those who read Marathi or who understand Marathi, for them, she is a co-founder of BHADIPA, Bharatiya Digital Party. And second one, the second author is Sandeep Saket, who has been writing on the film for last 10 years. I enjoyed reading the book. It is written in a captivating way. Doesn't look like they are the first time writing this book. I suggest all of you to read this book. This video will be available on my YouTube channel, on my Facebook page, Books From My Eyes, as well as on the LinkedIn. Any constructive feedback or criticism is welcome. If you like it, please like as well as offer your comments. Thank you so much.